As stories are passed along, they tend to evolve. Details are embellished, certain points are lost, and others added. Therefore, many stories seem unbelievable. However, in every story, there is room for both truth and fiction. This story is hard to believe, but it's up to you to decide whether it's true or not. Don't forget to share your opinion in the comments. Now go pour yourself a cup of coffee and make yourself comfortable as we begin. It happened deep in a taiga forest many years ago. Michael and Anne were a married couple who lived in a small village. Their children left for the city long ago, but the elderly couple preferred to stay behind, having no desire to get used to city life. They lived comfortably in familiar, albeit harsh, conditions. The winter was long and the summer was short, but the air was fresh and the food was natural. The only thing that bothered them was they sometimes felt lonely because their children and grandchildren were far away. One damp and chilly evening in late autumn, Michael lit a fire and made himself comfortable in the chair next to it while Anne sewed something at the table. The house was warm as the fire crackled, and the elderly couple spent the time reminiscing together about their children when they were young. Then a blizzard suddenly struck. The wind was blowing so hard that the roof seemed like it would blow right off the house. However, just as suddenly as it came, it dissipated. It became very quiet again, and in the sudden silence, Anne heard plaintive groans. At first, she thought she was imagining it, but soon the moans were heard closer and more distinctly. Michael went outside to check what was there and returned with a small, fluffy animal in his arms. It was a tiny gray wolf pup with blue eyes. Anne carefully took it from her husband and he nuzzled her palm in search of food. Anne put a saucer on the floor and poured some milk into it, but the puppy was so small and weak that he could not eat on his own, so Anne took a piece of cloth, dipped it in the milk, and carefully put it into the puppy's mouth. He started greedily sucking the milk from the fabric, so Anne sat down next to him on the floor and continued to dip the cloth in milk to feed him. Michael was at first hesitant to keep the animal, but seeing how her eyes were filled with love, he did not dare deprive her of this joy. So the puppy stayed with the elderly couple. Anne loved her new pet so much. The best table scraps went to him for lunch, and he sat on her lap all day. As the puppy grew bigger, he began to walk with Michael into the forest to hunt. Summer came and went, and before long it was winter again. The pup had grown into a large, strong, and beautiful wolf. The wolf would run into the forest, but always returned in the evening. However, one evening he did not come home. Anne stood on the porch for a long time and called for her pet, and Michael even tried to search for him in the forest, but it was too dark, so he decided to wait until morning. As soon as dawn came, Michael was going to go into the forest to search, but then they heard something scratching at the door. The wolf stood on the porch, looking very tired and hungry. In his teeth, he held some kind of card. Michael picked the card up and discovered it to be a driver's license. Where did the wolf get it? Michael went to the nearest village where there was a police station. There, he found out that the owner of the license had gone missing a week ago. The search didn't lead to anything, not even a trace of the person was found. Then Michael went back home and gave the license back to the wolf to sniff in the hopes that the animal would understand him and take him to the place where the card was found. As if he understood what was required of him, the wolf ran to the edge of the forest and sat down, expecting Michael to follow him. So they entered the forest together, and Michael followed him deep into the forest. Suddenly, the wolf howled loudly, and when Michael ran to him, he discovered a man lying among the trees in the snow. The back of his jacket was torn, apparently from teeth, and a long trail in the snow was found leading up to the body. It appeared he had been dragged by his jacket for a long distance. Michael checked his pulse and breathing and discovered that the man was still alive. Michael broke some branches off nearby trees and hastily put together a makeshift sled. Together with the wolf, they managed to put the man on the sled and pull him to the nearest village where he was immediately provided with medical assistance. Michael was bothered by the thought of what had happened to him in the forest, and he decided to return to the place where he had found him. He followed the trail to where the man had apparently been dragged from. It turned out that the trail led several kilometers into the forest, and when he reached the end, he saw a fallen tree. In the crevice of the trunk, he found a piece of cloth from the man's jeans. When that man regained consciousness, he told the amazing story of his salvation. It turned out that he had gotten lost in the deep taiga forest. Realizing he wouldn't last long in the cold, he attempted to knock down the dry trunk to make a fire, but something went wrong and the tree fell right on him. He passed out, and then he came to and saw that his leg was stuck in the crevice. It wasn't possible to pull it out on his own, and the man ended up losing consciousness again. The next time he came to, he was frozen in fear. A huge wolf was licking him. The beast helped him free his leg by pulling on the man's jeans until his leg was free. Then the wolf dragged the man through the snow for a long time before getting tired and retrieving Michael for help. Just like he himself was once saved by a man during a snowstorm, the wolf did not leave a man in trouble, but helped him in every way he could. If you liked this story, click the like button, write your thoughts about it in the comments below, subscribe to the channel, and click the bell so as not to miss our new videos.